Welcome to another bicycle adventure. This time, South Australia. I'm about 15 kilometres out of Renmark. Just next to the Murray River. Well, I'm just leaving the Murray River now. Climbing out of the Murray River. There's a lookout looking over the Murray River and the surrounding area. Let's go check it out. This is a view of the Murray River just outside Renmark, South Australia. That's looking at the Red Cliffs. Now, they describe this area as the Mallee. That's an Aborigine word meaning lots of varieties of eucalypts. My main load today is water. I'm going for 4 days, but there's not going to be any water stops. So I'm carrying 19 litres of water. It's pretty much one of my back panniers. That's all it is water. And the rest is food and a tent on the other side and sleeping bag. And then the front's pretty much water, and the handlebar bag is all the camera equipment. Yeah, so all along the road are these almond shells with almonds in. Don't mind almonds myself. A little snack. Right, perfect. And the road goes into the distance. It's a pretty good road at the moment. It's just gravel, but yeah, quite easy rolling. Truck driver slowed right down for me. I was expecting me covered in dust. That's very rare. See, that's what I expected the other truck to do. You can't see a thing, and all you're doing is eating dust. Now, it's a dry weather road only, and I've looked at the long range forecast for 10 days, and there's no rain on the forecast. I'm not even carrying a jacket this time, which is the first time ever. Trying to hold back on equipment or weight. Yeah. Having issues with the pack rack at the back. I'm clearly going to have to buy a new pack rack. At the present, because it wobbles so much, these bits now are hitting the tyre. This pack rack, it just keeps flexing. See the flex in it? I mean, it's lightweight, but it's too lightweight. It's a problem. I let the tyres down a little bit too now. I'm starting to get a bit of sand. I've changed my tyres too. Hear that noise? That's the pack rack flexing with those black bits hitting the tyre. Not good at all. The land's pretty dry at the moment. That's wheat fields to the right. They clearly need a lot of rain to grow any wheat this winter. The road's not too bad. It's got a bit of soft sand in places at the moment. But with the 4-inch jumbo gym swayable tyres, it's doing okay. Oh. Have to open and shut a gate. Then I'm going to continue straight on But I should actually get into a state forest soon. Well, over there, very soon. Yeah, it's just flexing that pack rack. I mean, I've got a fair bit. I've got 10 litres of water in here, or 12, and a fair bit of camping gear in there. But just flexing, and you can hear it. It's not puncturing anything, but don't like sound on a bike that shouldn't be there. This is South Australia on this side, and this, Mildura Rural City. But we're not going there. We're going straight into this state forest and continuing along. So I'm obviously back in Victoria now. The most livable, people-friendly community in Australia. That's Mildura. Maybe. I don't like being on main roads. It's much more enjoyable being on these forest roads in a state park. I'm not expecting to see a whole lot of people. If I see anyone, I'll be surprised. Out here. The humming of a fat bike with the wide tyres. The 4-inch jumbo gyms. And I've got green slime, or as I'm naming it, alien blood. So if I get a puncture, it seals it, sort of thing. If you get a spike through it, up to 3 millimetres wide. And I'm running tubeless at the moment. I've got one spare tube, because that's all I've got. At least I went and bought new patches, or from the Big W or whatever. So I do have patches that I actually work with glue, unlike my last dilemma at Right, where none of the patches worked. It's definitely a warm day. I thought it was only meant to get to about 32, but it feels about 34. Which is definitely warm. I don't mind up to about 35. Once you get to 40, it's getting pretty warm to ride a bike in. Great fat bike territory at the moment. Beautiful, peaceful roads or tracks. And quite easy. Not expecting many hills out here. A few bumps will be about it. The main thing will be maybe some soft sand in sections. I looked at the map and there's some sand ridges that said 3 metres high in places. Not quite here though. It's a lot different to the Alpine area I was in. Mount Fainter, Falls Creek area. This is definitely nothing like that. And we're up to the state forest. Berribee. B-E-R-R-I-B-E-E. Motor vehicles and trail bikes must be registered. Drivers and riders must be licensed and stay on formed roads. I'm on a bicycle, does that mean I have to stay on formed roads? Can I just follow a kangaroo track, maybe? It's possible. I just go cross country. We'll see. I've got sort of a route marked out on the map, but you've always got to be flexible when you're on tour. Things always change. Kind of surreal riding this at the moment compared to where I've come from. It's the Mallee region, but it feels like, I guess it's sort of the outback. It's not the desert outback yet, but we're close to Murray Sunset National Park, even though we're in the state forest, Berribee or whatever it is. There are a few deserts around, not far away from here, so. Murray Sunset National Park. Off-road driving prohibited. Dogs, cats and firearms. So obviously, this is Murray Sunset National Park now. And I'm in the Victorian side. That's South Australia, just on that other side of the fence. I probably should jump on that road. It's probably a bit easier, but backpack flexing. It's definitely a lot of flies at the moment. Haven't had flies like this for a long time. Just swallowed one before, or just half swallowed it. Did a bit of regurgitation. Some little hills. Well, almost mounds, but little hills. It's not dead flat at least. Quite fast rolling at the moment. There was sand, like I said, for a little bit, but the rest of it's pretty much like this. It's almost like a clay surface. A few rocks and mixed in. It's about 10 to 4 in the afternoon. Obviously. So, might go a little bit further and then try and find a campsite somewhere. What will the view be like on the other side? Right, this is sandy over here. My track turn off. I missed this just before. Didn't even realise. Don't think it gets used much. Thank you. I'm on the track by the map. Just doesn't get used much, but look at it. Kangaroos have gone and used it. Oh yeah. There's still tire marks, but it seems to be tire marks going everywhere, to tell you the truth. Sun's about to go down, might go do some time lapse. Go for a walk this direction. Where will the wildlife be? Bike's packed up, still having dilemmas with the backpack rack flexing too much and stuff like that, but we'll persevere and then slowly I'll figure out this bike how it's going to work. Drank these yesterday luckily because they split anyway, which I expected really, but they got me through the day, which was good. Got my oil here, my rid to keep the flies away, mosquitoes and stuff like that. Got my sunscreen on, which you have to, especially in Australia. Got my quad lock bike system there, which works really well, which I run memory map, which I use for my navigation purposes. Let's get going. Now you can sort of make out the track. It's not that well defined. As I was saying before, I'm using memory map, which has a lot of the HEMA maps on it. And I'm using a 250,000 scale at the moment. Obviously it shows tracks, but they're very old tracks. Because obviously people don't drive along these anymore. But being on a bike and a fat bike, it's okay. It's kind of good. Not expecting to see any traffic on this one. You can tell by the trees. It's been quite some time since it's been used. But these days with GPS giving you a location of where you are, oh, it's so much easier. To navigate this with just a map, you wouldn't be known sure if you're going the right way or the wrong way. Nice temperature at the moment. It's probably about 22 degrees, something like that. Probably gonna get up to about 35 today, I'd say. It's pretty warm for April. So I'm gonna go through Murray Sunset National Park today and probably come out just near the Murray River. So I'm sort of aiming at the moment. If my bike was running good, I'd go for a long tour, but it's really not yet. I'm gonna have to do modifications and stuff. I'd love to go full time on this bike and just travel the whole country until it's running correctly and not getting the speed wobbles, and I need a little bit more cash, obviously, to save a few more things. Maybe one day. I think it's more of a kangaroo trail by the look of it. Little bit of wind starting to blow from the north. The roads, or the tracks just to the left of me. But it seems like, because they made the track, it lifted up the soil and that's where all the plants are growing. whereas the animal track just to the side here, yeah, it's a lot better. Just gotta keep looking at the GPS and making sure I know where I'm going. It's obvious this was old farmland or where they used to graze cattle basically. And they've just reclaimed it as a national park because the tracks go everywhere and there's old bits of tin and stuff everywhere. Got whacked in the eye just before. The scrub got really thick. And yeah, one of the branches just went whack, smack in the eye. Still hurting a little bit. Yeah, it'll be okay. Some bones of the kangaroo. There's one thing, there's lots of bones around, but you see the kangaroos. That's laid to rest. Get their water from. There were a fair few kangaroos out last night and I'm going for a walk. A lot of bird life, but birds can fly a long way to get a drink. It's a bit harder when you're a marsupial. Gotta be an old dam. Yep. There goes kangaroos, look at them all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. The track's a little bit hard to follow in places, to say the least. Always keep your eyes open when you're cycling along. There's little tracks like this. Looks like there'd be no wildlife. Just out the corner of my eye, this would be shingleback. That's a shingleback. See, that's his defense mechanism. Big wide mouth. It's called a shingle back obviously because the roof houses used to have shingles on them. And if you look at his back, they look like shingles. He's a nice one. We'll leave him alone. Hey, mister. Hey. I could pick him up. They're not really that bad. Quite harmless. I'm sure he'd bite hard. And he's shedding his skin. Anyway, goodbye, Mr. Shingleback. Bike's going better today. Now, it's a bit more major of a gravel road, this one. Pretty much follow this a straight line up till I get to near the Murray River. Getting a little bit sandy again, probably for the top ridges mainly, as you go over these little hills. Lots of emus about, but they take off very quick as soon as they see you. They're 100 metres away and they're gone in a flash. Now I head north, which means I'm going to be straight into a headwind, but not in a big hurry. I'm not doing huge distances today. Get ready. There goes an emu. They're fast. There goes an emu. I've got the camera on linear and I've put it on zoom. Didn't even know you could do that. Learning new stuff about this GoPro 7 Hero Black all the time. Getting towards the Murray River. There's obviously floodplains. When it does rain, which is pretty rare out here at the moment, as you can tell by all the trees that are dying. I turn right very, very shortly. Hopefully get out of this headwind a bit. Really quite strong. I turn right now towards Ned's Corner. Pretty sure, yep. Semi-main road, the mail route, you see. I'm not going straight into the headwind anymore. Well, it was quite picking up to the street. Could actually put a fair bit more pressure into the tyres now, but I'll be able to do it later. It's about 12 o'clock. Probably be at my destination in an hour and a half, something like that. A fair few emus out in the dry lake there. Lots and lots. Four emus on the top of the hill on the right. Wait, see. Should get the cover of the trees soon. A little bit of cover. It's getting warm. Whew. Getting warm. I didn't realise. I've assumed this is the Murray. What else could be this size? That for a big carp. It's 20 to 3 in the afternoon. And it's very warm. Very, very warm. Had a bit of a rest. I'd like to get to my campsite. So that's enough for the day. Follow an animal track, I reckon. Find somewhere to camp. Shit comes out near Lindsay Creek, just over there. Where the animal tracks go. Must be where the excitement is. That should mean that they come in at night for a drink at least. So you get to see some wildlife.
Amount of animals use this.
It's just a matter of finding a shady spot. And it is. Perfect. This will be my campsite for the night. Shade, glorious shade. And some ducks. Wood ducks. Off they go. 4 or 5 wood ducks. Lots of wood ducks. I'm just next to the Lindsay River, which yesterday I thought it was the Murray, but it's not. It's actually the Lindsay River. The Murray's probably another 2 kilometres that way, like I thought. It's pretty big though, I'm surprised. There's been a lot of wildlife here last night, where I camped just back before. Follow an animal track back to the main road. It's a lot cooler today. Yeah, when it rains out here, this black soil, it just turns to mud. Wouldn't be able to ride this if it rained. Even on a fat bike, it just turns, just sticks to your tires. You wouldn't be able to. This is the main road just over here. If I ever get there. It's short distance. Swung round to a southwesterly. It's pretty much coming from that direction, the wind now. So I guess I'll have a bit of a headwind today, but that's okay. Now this is the main road again. You call it a main road. I'm expecting today to be pretty much riding on a road like this and the scenery to mainly remain the same. So I probably won't do a huge amount of video today. probably all look like this. There might be a few little hills, bumps over there in the distance, which we've got to go over, but don't expect it to change much today. It's quite nice riding at the moment. In the middle of the road, you get the corrugations. If you go like here, like that. So often just on the shoulder somewhere, say about here where you can see the firmer mud. The rolling's quite nice. There are some sandy sections along here. This is pretty sandy. It's not a problem. Now, we're getting towards farmland again. See the green on the horizon? That's farmland. Now, I'll probably make it back today. Push on. Almost 12, getting towards 12 now. If I keep pushing on, water's getting lower anyway, so. I came out into farmland, and this is actually a farmer's property, but luckily I spoke to him and he's an actual cyclist. Not so much fat bike cycling, but road cycling, but he's like, yeah, no, no, and he showed me how to get through. He's like, no, no, go through my property this way and it'll come out to the national park. And then I can follow it along the river. So that's pretty nice of the farmer. Because I'm actually in someone's property at the moment. I kind of looked at the map and it's, this is the problem with some of the HEMA maps, the 250,000 scale. It doesn't really tell you where farmers' properties begin and other stuff. Oh well, feels really nice. So this is where I wanted to ride. Didn't think I was going to be able to then. He showed me through his house basically. He's like, yeah, no, no, follow me. And he drove right through his property, past his house, and he's like, there, go that way. So that's pretty nice. Pretty sure the little track I want to come out is that direction. Don't want to go through that there, which is almonds. That farmer just said the almonds, they use lots and lots of water. Hoping up there, to the right of this orchard, should be able to get my way through. Hope. Soon find out, I guess. Good. There's the orchard there of almonds. And I'm just gonna miss it, which is good. There is a gate up ahead, soon see. Okay, got a gate. Open. I've almost done a loop. In these 3 days, I'll be back to the road that I started on 3 days ago. Very short. And then in about 2 hours, I'll be back to my other campsite. I went that way last time. Well, 3 days ago. So, well, that's pretty much it, I guess. 2 hours back on this road and I'll be back. Hey, that was a good little adventure. Learned a lot about the bike again. You know what I've got to do, hopefully, when we get it working properly. That's it for another adventure. Thanks for watching.